हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू योर साइंस क्लास। सो स्टूडेंट, इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट दैट ऑफ द कॉन्सेंट्रिक सर्कल एंड वी हैड डिस्कस दैट हाउ कॉन्सेंट्रिक सर्कल फॉर्म्ड बिकॉज ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रिक करंट। एंड टुडे वी विल गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द राइट हैंड थंब रूल। ओके, राइट हैंड थंब रूल। सो सी, this is a rule to find the direction of the magnetic field which is produced by the current carrying conductor around that of the so how can we, this is a very convenient method by which we can find the direction of the magnetic field which is associated with the current carrying conductor. How? Now see here. Here it is written, that is, imagine that you are holding a current carrying a straight conductor in your right hand such that the thumb, it points towards the conductor, towards the direction of the current. And what about the fingers? Then your fingers which wrap around it, this is your finger, students. All the fingers which wrap around it, it will represent the magnetic field. Okay, so here the current is what? You can see the thumb here. The thumb is in the downward direction. Why is this so? Because the flow of current is in the downward direction. And the magnetic field, you can see it is around that of the straight conductor, current carrying conductor. So this fingers which wrap around that of the conductor, it will represent the magnetic field. Okay, and this we call as the right hand thumb rule. So when we take our right hand, and the right hand here, the thumb is what? It will represent the current, and the fingers which wrap or which hold that of the wire will represent the magnetic field. Now what will happen if suppose we will change the direction of the current? Okay. So, if we will change the direction of the current, suppose it will be in the upward direction. This time, the magnetic field is produced from this side and coming from this side, right? When we change the current direction, if suppose it will start moving in the upward direction, at that time, it will be, the magnetic field also changes. Now, you see here in this picture also, students, as you will find that here the current is moving in the downward direction, and thus there is a formation of the concentric circle is formed, right? This is the circle which is formed around that of the conductor, and this is the right hand rule also. Right hand rule explain that if we will, if the this arrow is showing the current, the movement of the current, so if the movement of the current in the downward direction, so the magnetic field which is present around it, the fingers which is holding, with the fingers of the hand will indicate the direction of the magnetic field. So suppose if the current is moving here in the downward direction, if it is moving in a clockwise direction, as you can see here, the movement is what? It is in the clockwise direction. It will start from here and move like this, right? What will happen if suppose the current will start moving in the upward direction? What kind of, is there any change will you see in the magnetic field lines also? Yes. If the current is moving in the upward direction, then instead of the clockwise, the current, it will start moving from this, like this. Okay, so this is what, as you changes the current, the movement of the magnetic field lines also changes. The direction also of that of the magnetic field around the conductor also changes. It become clockwise. So if suppose in the first one, if the conductor is flowing in the, if the current is moving in the upward direction, so the magnetic field produced around the conductor is anti-clockwise direction. And if it is moving in the downward direction, if the current is flowing in the downward direction, the magnetic field produced here, it will be in the clockwise direction. So this is what, student, this is the right hand thumb rule. So here a question is also given. Now see here, the current through a horizontal power line flows in east to west direction. What is the direction of a magnetic field at a point directly below it and at a point directly above it? So if the current is in the east-west direction, then by applying the thumb rule, we will get the magnetic field below or above the wire. It turns either clockwise, and when the it will if it is viewed from the east end, then it will be anti-clockwise. It means, suppose if the current is moving in a west side, then the movement will be, the turning, the magnetic field that is produced here, it will be clockwise. And if it will be at the east direction, then the magnetic field which is produced here, it will be in anti-clockwise direction. So with the help of the right thumb hand rule, we can tell that if a current which is carried by a straight wire, a straight conductor, then we are able to find the magnetic field also, what is the direction of the magnetic field lines. Now till that we have studied that magnetic field is what, it is basically produced when the current flow through it. And if we talk about the straight wire, so in the straight current carrying conductor, the current, it flows in such a way that it moves around it, the magnetic field which is produced, it moves around it. It is the fingers which is holding that of the wire will help in telling the magnetic field lines. So is the same kind of a magnetic field will be produced if we will take not a straight wire, but we will take a circular loop. So suppose we have taken a straight wire and be given a shape of a circle or a loop, a circular loop, what kind of a magnetic field line will be produced here? So the pattern, as you can see here, it is so what happens if we will take a magnetic field due to current passing through a circular loop? This is what, student, as you can see in the picture, it is a circular loop, right? So what kind of a direction of the magnetic field produced if the current flows through them? Actually, in a circular wire, this circular wire is made up of a very, very small straight wire. Suppose we will going to take here a small portion, this portion of that of the conductor, then it will behave like a straight current carrying conductor, straight wire current carrying conductor. So we can say here that if suppose the magnetic field line is produced like this, then what happened here in this direction, the current which is moving around it, the current which is moving, it will goes inside it. So we will, when we keep our thumb inside, then the current will start flowing like this, right? So we can say here that we will consider each of the part of the circular loop as a very, very small straight current carrying conductor, as a straight wire, and this straight wire will start producing a magnetic field lines around it. And as it will comes closer, you can see here, as the magnetic field line comes closer, it will behave like a straight current. Okay, it will behave like a straight current, students. One second. A straight field is obtained because of this. Okay, so when the magnetic field lines come closer to each other, it will looks like a straight one. And here when it goes far, a large loop is present, a small loop when it is close to that of the magnet, as it goes far away, a large loop is formed here, a large loop is formed here. So I said that here it behaves, the circular loop, it behaves like a small current carrying conductor, small straight wire. So since there are a lot of straight wires are there which is carrying the same current, thus the amount of the magnetic field in case of the circular loop, it will be much more than that of the straight wire. Okay, as you can see here that each of the wire, here this blue is actually showing the current is moving along with it. This is the movement of the current, and the kind of a magnetic field produced is shown by here. So you can see that as it will be very close to that of the wire, so it forms a closed circular loop, but as it goes far away, then the loop is formed. It will be also very far, large loop or large arc will be formed here. Here a small arc is formed, but as it goes far away, then a large arc is formed here, which help us in telling that the magnetic field line near, it will be stronger. Okay, so a circular loop, it is having the, it flows or it allows the more magnetic field will be produced here, since consisting a lot of a straight wires. So here you can see it is written that the magnetic field which is produced by a current carrying straight wire, it depends inversely on the distance from it. Similarly, at every point of a current carrying circular loop, the concentric circle representing the magnetic field around it, and it would become larger and larger as we move away from the wire. So there you can see the concentric circle is actually telling the magnetic field, and as it moves away from that of the circular loop, as it moves away from that of the coil, it will form a circular loop, and the circular loop, the arc of the circular loop will becomes larger and larger. Okay, now every point on the wire current carrying would give rise to a magnetic field appearing as a straight line at the center of the loop. By applying the right hand rule, it is easy to check that every section of the wire contribute to the magnetic field line in the same direction within the loop. So here every section, a very small section of this current carrying circular loop is what it behaves like a straight current carrying conductor, and due to which if you look at any of the section, if you take any of the part of this, then it will start behaving like a straight current carrying conductor and produces the magnetic field, and collectively the whole circular loop will going to produce a magnetic field lines, as you can see in this picture. Okay, so this is the magnetic field line produced by a current carrying circular loop. Now there is a point that we should remember, that magnetic field line which is produced by a current carrying wire, it depends directly on the current passing through it. And if there is a circular coil having n turns, the field produces n times as large as the produced by the single turn. You see, the magnetic field, it is produced, it depend on the current passing through it. More will be the current, more will be the magnetic field produced. And if the number of coils are more, circular coils are more, then the field which is produced here, it will also be very large, right? So number of coiling, it means number of turns are there in the coil, so the current will also becomes larger, and when the current is larger, students, then the field is also very very large. Now see here, what happened if suppose a coil is, a single coil is there, so the magnetic field line, the magnetic is a circular coil, is a, the magnetic field line will be like this, this much only. Now there is another wire is there which is coiled together, or another turn is there, then what happened, there is another, this will also going to form a concentric circle around it, and this concentric circle is what, it is actually the magnetic field. So the magnetic field which is produced by the first turn and that of the second turn of the circular coil will be added. And as it will add up, it will going to increase the magnetic field around it, and the strength of the magnetic field will also become larger. That is why it is written here that if there is a circular coil having n turns, the field produces n time as large that produced by a single turn. So in a single turn, the magnetic field produced here, it will be much more than the magnetic field, it will be the more number of the coiling will be there, the more number of turns will be there, the more magnetic field will be there, because all the magnetic field will, which is moving in the same direction, it will add up, and when it will add up, the effect will be double. For this, there is an experiment that we can perform. You see here in this one. As you can see in this picture, student, this is what? This is the circular coil, as you can see it properly. This is what, student? This is the circular coil. And this this is what circular coil is, consisting a lot of turns. You can see by the lining itself that it consisting a lot of turns in it. Now, this circular coil is fixed in a cardboard. This is what? This is a cardboard. Here it is a cardboard, and there are two holes in which the this is fixed, right? And you can see that through this there is wire which is attached with the circular loop, and it is connected to the battery. Key is also inserted in it. Now what happened when the current start passing through it? Then, and one more thing that you have to do, you have taken a cardboard in which you made two holes, and from the two holes the circular loop is emerging out, circular loop is coming out, right? So here you will find out that if on a cardboard you will sprinkle the iron fillings on it, a lot of iron fillings on it, then when the current will pass through it, you will find that the iron fillings will get, the iron fillings which is present here, it will arrange itself in a pattern, and that pattern is the similar to the pattern that we have found in the first one. So it behaves like a straight current carrying conductor in which the concentric circle is also formed here. So we can say that even if a circular loop is there, then it will going to produce a pattern of a iron filling. That pattern can be seen to us. So magnetic field, which is this pattern, is to be telling what, that the circular loop is producing or is making a magnetic field around it, and just because of that the iron filling, they have arranged themselves in a, okay. So here there is a formation of a circular loop, and this circular loop, it tells that the magnetic field is produced by the there is a formation of a concentric circle which help is telling that magnetic field is produced due to that of the circular coil. Now let us see that what is the kind of a magnetic field is produced due to the current which flow in a solenoid. So before we go further, we must know the solenoid. What is the solenoid, students? So as you can see here in the picture, this is a solenoid. Solenoid is what? It is a coiled of many turns of an insulated copper wire which is closely wound in the shape of a tight spring, right? So here you can see it is basically a lot of turns has been given to a copper wire, insulated copper wire. Why they are insulated? So that the short circuit do not occur between them. So they are wound coil of an insulated copper wire, and or we can say they are long helically wound coil of an insulated copper wire. What happened in this solenoid? You can see one end of this solenoid is what? One end of this solenoid behave like a north pole, and the other end it behaves like a south pole. And these two wires which came out through this solenoid, it is connected to a battery, and when the electric current flows through the solenoid, a magnetic field is set up around it, around that of the solenoid, which is similar to the magnetic field of a bar magnet. So you have seen in case of a bar magnet also, the magnetic field produced around it when we provide a current to it. Similarly, in case of a solenoid also, magnetic field is produced when the current flows through it. Now let us see that how the current flows through the solenoid. Basically, what happened here, in case of a solenoid, I said that it behaves like a two pole. It acts as a two pole, that is north pole and south pole. Now see, what happened, if suppose the current is moving in a clockwise direction, then the coiling that you will see, it is that one end of the solenoid, it will behave like a south pole. It will behave like a south pole. So if the current is flowing in a clockwise direction, so one end it is behave like a south pole, and if the current is moving in anti-clockwise direction, then the other end will behave like a north pole. So since there is a formation of the two poles, the loop, the face of the loop, it behaves like a south pole if the current is flowing in the clockwise, and the face of the loop behave like a north pole if the current is moving in an anti-clockwise direction. So it behaves like a south pole or that of the north pole, due to which we can say that it actually behaves like a bar magnet which consisting of the two faces. Okay, so solenoid is what, it behaves like a bar magnet. Now there are some of the characteristic of the magnetic field, or the magnetic field which is produced due to the current carrying that of the solenoid. First one, that the magnetic field which is inside to that of the long solenoid, it is what, it is uniform and strong. As you can see here, this, the magnetic field which is produced here, it is the same at all the point, it is uniform and it is strong. Even the magnetic field also, as you can see here students, the magnetic field are what, as they are coming like this, so they are what, at the middle they are actually parallel to each other. Okay, so this is the straight magnetic field which are very parallel to each other and they are very close to each other. It is because of that only the magnetic field line which is produced here, it is strong and it is uniform. As the magnetic field will goes, or it will move towards the end of the solenoid. See, when it enters into the solenoid, it become very close to each other. It will become parallel to each other, due to which it like look like a straight one. Okay, that's why they are very strong. They are uniform. But as it starts moving at the edge of the solenoid, at the end of the solenoid, it will start forming a long loop, or they will get spread out. They will start spreading out from each other like this. It will get spread out from each other. So it is because of that the magnetic field which is produced by the solenoid outside to that of the solenoid, it is non-uniform and weak. So the magnetic field which is entering, or the magnetic field which is produced or coming to the center of the solenoid, that will are straight, uniform and strong. They are parallel to each other. While the magnetic field line, as it goes away from the solenoid, you can see here that the kind of a loop which is formed here, they are weak, they are not straight to each other, they are not uniform. Okay, so outside they are non-uniform and weak also. When the magnetic field line inside to the solenoid, it is from south pole to the north pole, and outside it is from north pole to that of the south pole. So suppose this is south and this is north, so the movement will occur from the south as it enter into the solenoid. It is from south, from that of the north pole, and outside to that of the solenoid, it is from the north pole to that of the south pole. It is because of that only it forms a circular loop around it. So if this is south, this is north, so as you can see here, this is entering from the south to that of the north, and from here, from north to the south, it will complete the circular loop. Now it behaves like a bar magnet, student, like as in case of a bar magnet, the magnetic field produced, similarly the kind of a magnetic field which is produced by the solenoid is like a bar magnet only. Now what is the use of the solenoid? Why do we use solenoid, student? So first of all, let me tell you that solenoid, it produces the strong magnetic field, and this strong magnetic field, it can be used to magnetize a magnetic material. Magnetic, see, you cannot magnetize all the material, all the metals. There are some of the materials which can be magnetized easily. When I said magnetize, it means by producing electricity, by flowing electricity or by giving electricity to it and helping it to produce a magnetic field around it. And such magnets who are formed by this method are also called as an electromagnet. So a strong magnetic field is produced inside a solenoid, and that can be used to magnetize the piece of a magnetic material like soft iron core. Yes, basically it is the soft iron core which is used to convert it into a magnetized material or into an electromagnet. In the highest section, when you will going to study about the electromagnetism in detail, then you will come to know that the electromagnet is formed by keeping the object into the coil of the solenoid. When we keep the object into the coil of the solenoid, then what happens? The current is continuously flowing through it, and due to which the magnetic field is generated, magnetic field is produced around it, and this magnetic field make a material, it will magnetize the material, the iron rod, and that we call as a soft iron. Like in case of a soft iron also, we can convert it into a magnetized material, and the material which is formed due to this magnetized method, that is also called as electromagnet. Okay, so this is how we can make a current carrying conductor into electromagnet. Let me tell you, what do we understand by the electromagnet, students? So in an electromagnet is what? That is, when a soft iron bar, it is placed in a solenoid, then what happened? It becomes magnet. How it becomes magnet? See, in the solenoid, when an iron rod or a soft iron is kept there, then it will start. We are continuously giving current to it, and due to which the continuous flow of the current will help in producing a lot of a magnetic field around it. And even we can increase the strength by increasing the current of the solenoid or by increasing the number of turns of the solenoid. So number of turn will also increases the magnetic field, and the number of a current, amount of current flowing through it, we know that the magnetic field line depend upon the current flowing through it. So the amount of the current will also help in increasing the increasing the magnetism in that of the iron bar or soft iron bar. So this is the two method by which we can increase the strength of the electromagnet. Electromagnet is used for many things, student. One of the thing that you have studied about is the magnetic separation, where we use the electromagnet in order to separate the magnetic material from heap of garbage. Okay, so this is the magnetic field due to current in a solenoid.